Tammy is buying a new computer that has an LED display. Tammy connects the computer to her home network. The computer has a MAC address and an IP address. A paragraph is given about MAC addresses and IP addresses. Complete the paragraph using the list of terms given. Not all terms need to be used. Before we answer this question, we're going to quickly go through what a MAC address is and what an IP address is. A MAC address, otherwise known as a Media Access Control address, is an address that is used to identify a device on a network. The MAC address is always assigned by the manufacturer of the device, and it will almost never change. The MAC address is made up of two different parts, the manufacturer's ID code and the serial ID code for the device. This creates a unique address for every single device. The address is represented as hexadecimal and generally has six pairs of numbers separated with either a dash or a colon. An example looks like this. These first six hexadecimal digits are the manufacturer's ID, and the second half is the serial ID. Moving on to an IP or an Internet Protocol address. There are two main types of IP addresses, the IPv4 and IPv6. IPv4 is an old structure created back in 1983 that uses 32 bits to create a numerical IP address. Here is an example of an IPv4 address. We say it has 32 bits since each of these four numbers has a maximum number of 255. This means that each decimal number can be represented using 8 binary bits. 8 binary bits times 4 numbers gives us 32 binary bits. An IPv6 address is much longer. IPv6 uses 128 bits and is usually represented as hexadecimal. Here is an example of an IPv6 address. You can see it's much longer and it looks similar to a MAC address. It is split up into 8 sections, each containing 4 hexadecimal digits. One hexadecimal digit can be represented using 4 binary bits. Multiply that by 4 and we get 16. If we multiply 16 by 8, we get 128 binary bits. An IP address is either assigned by router or by network software and can change based on your physical location. One way you can visualize how the IP address and MAC address are different is with this example. An IP address can be thought of as your geographical location, whereas a MAC address can be thought of as your name. Your geographical location can change. You can move house, you can move country, you could move continents, and your geographical address will be based on where you're living. Your name doesn't change. You are assigned a name when you're born, and generally, you don't change your name. This works the same for devices. Let's now go ahead and answer the first question. We've been given a list of terms. We need to fill in the blank spaces so that the sentence makes sense. Starting off, this says a MAC address is a media access blank address. Notice that media access are the first two words, forming the acronym of MAC. So the last one must be control, which is a term given here. Let's write that in. We can now cross out this term. The next sentence says, a network device has a blank MAC address that can help blank the device in the network. There could be a number of words that fit into the space before MAC address. One technique you can use, if you're unsure of what word fits in, is to read the sentence using each word in the list of terms. We can go down the list of terms until we find a term that makes sense in the context of the sentence. Whilst going down the list, you may get to dynamic. A network device has a dynamic MAC address. This makes sense grammatically, but would be incorrect since MAC addresses cannot be dynamic. Only IP addresses can be dynamic. The only term that makes sense in this context is unique. So we'll fill that in and we'll cross out unique. Moving on, a network device has a unique MAC address that can help blank the device in the network. If a MAC address is unique, that should allow us to identify the device in the network. The next sentence says an IP address is an internet blank address. This is similar to the first term, where internet is the first word in the acronym IP. The second word is protocol, which also exists in our list of terms. Let's write that down. The last sentence says an IP address can be static or blank. Again, we can go down our list of words, and the only word that makes sense here is dynamic. A dynamic IP address means that the address can change each time the device is connected to a network. A static IP address means that the IP address will always be the same every time you connect the device to a network. Let's go ahead and move on with the next question. The next question says, a computer can have both a MAC address and an IP address. Four statements are given about MAC addresses and IP addresses. Tick to show whether each statement is true or false. The first statement says, a MAC address is unique to a computer on a network. This is going to be true since all MAC addresses are unique. The next statement says, once an IP address has been set, it cannot be changed. That is false based on this analogy that I gave, where an IP address is similar to your geolocation. Your IP address can change based on where you are in the world. The next statement says, a MAC address is made up of the computer's serial number and the IP address. This is false, as a MAC address is made up of the manufacturer's ID and the serial ID. The last statement says, if a computer does not have an IP address, it cannot communicate with another device using the internet. This is true, since whenever you connect to a router, which connects you to the internet, you are assigned an IP address. If you do not have an IP address, you can't communicate with other computers. And there we go. That is this question complete.